Welcome back to MacroMagic with Michelle. I am your host, Michelle Williams. You can find me on Instagram at the_freedom_fairy. You can also find my YouTube channel, The Freedom Fairy, and check out my Patreon, patreon.com/the_freedom_fairy. And speaking of my Patreon, I just added a new benefit. Now, this benefit applies to all the tiers, except the tip jar tier. So, this benefit is basically inspiration and recipes. So, I take a picture of what I'm eating that day, and below it, I give a recipe, and I give a little bit more, a little bit information about the food, like, you know, what it can help you with, you know, whatever energy you're looking for. I talk a little bit more on the energy of that food. So go ahead and check out my Patreon if you want more access to my knowledge, and I would love to have you there. So I know it's been a very, very long time. Maybe not that long, but I haven't been so consistent with my podcast, and this is a reason why. There's a few reasons, but I do have Scorpio in the third house. The third house is communication. And if you know anything about Scorpios, they don't necessarily like to talk. They don't really like to talk. And that may come as a shock to some of you who follow me on my social media, especially YouTube. For the first 7 or 8 years, pretty much all my YouTube videos were half an hour, 45 minutes long, because I talk so much. But that's because I have Gemini, my MC is Gemini in the 10th house, which is your reputation, public image. So everyone knows that Geminis like to talk a lot. So there's a lot to come that comes into play. So I just want you guys to know I'm so thankful for everyone who keeps tuning back into my podcast. And I have gotten so much encouragement lately for my podcast. And if you didn't check out some of the interviews I've been doing recently, I've been so thankful that people have been reaching out to me to be interviewed for their different projects, and people have been responding well to those collaborations as well. So it's really been encouraging me to get back onto my podcasting game, and I have plenty of topics I would like to talk about. I have plenty of guests I would like to invite on, but this episode I just want to kind of catch up with you guys and let you know where I'm at. So another thing that I wanted to let you all know about is there are going to be some changes to my Etsy shop. My Etsy shop has a combination of readings, different kinds of readings. I do 9-star key astrology readings, base readings, different psychic readings, like communication with the fairy realm, communication with the unicorn, spirit guides, and just general, you know, psychic readings for anyone who is looking for some guidance, looking to speak with a loved one that has passed away, and also my long-distance energy healings. So there's going to be some updates made, mainly when it comes to the 9-star key astrology readings. I have gotten a lot more sales with that form of reading the past few months, and I'm so thankful to everyone who, you know, has purchased from me, and I've gotten such positive feedback on that style of reading. But why I'm thinking I'm going to be adjusting that is because there's so much that I provide for that reading that it takes hours, literally. So, I honestly feel like, and different clients have told me that I should charge more for that reading. So what I'm going to do is break it down, you know, have some lower price points, but with those lower price points, it's going to be a specific area of your reading, and then I'll charge a higher price for the full reading. You understand? So, 'cause yeah, I mean, there's just so much to say in a 9-star key reading. And honestly, I'm going to be real with you guys. Even after I finish the reading and I send it off, I'm like, oh my God, I could have said so much more. So, yeah, so that's what's coming to my Etsy shop. I'm also working on, creating a different kind of reading, and this reading is going to be because I get so often people are like, what do I eat? What do I eat? And I feel you already know what to eat. You do. But I understand, you know, a lot of people are confused. You know, there's so much mixed messages, mixed information, and it's designed to confuse you. But deep down, your body knows what's best for you. And, you know, that's a whole process of letting go of the diet mentality, which I have a webinar available that you can still access called Erasing Diet Mentality if you would like further assistance with that. I really believe that's the first step towards a healthy body, a healthy mind, a healthy relationship with food. That's the first step. So that's a part of my webinar series that I just started, Healthy Eating Basics. So I will leave the link for that if you would like to join. It's actually free. I messed up when I was creating the webinar. I initially meant to charge for it, but you know, I messed it up. So it's actually free. So what a lucky mistake for all of you, right? What's it called? But in the future, they're going to be monetized. So, but yes, I really feel like connecting to your intuition is one of the first steps for knowing what to eat. But I know a lot of people, you know, they feel like they don't have time, they don't have the energy. A lot of people just want guidance. A lot of people do want people to tell them what to do. I understand that. I understand that. I've been there so many times, not just with food, but, with other things. You know, sometimes you feel so lost in life, and it doesn't matter what area of life, you know, you feel so confused, so lost, and you just want answers, you just want guidance. So, I'm creating a reading that will help people, know, you know, what they should eat. But it's going to take a lot, from me to be able to help people in this way, because when I suggest, you know, foods for people, it's not one size fits all. I can't just be out here saying everyone needs to do this, everyone needs to eat this, everyone, has to not eat this, you know, is a whole thing, because there's so many things to take into consideration. First of all, what are your goals? What are your health goals? What are your life goals? What are your health concerns at this time? Like, do you have a chronic illness? You know, are you sick with something? Do you have mental illness? Where do you live? What's your budget? What's your food preference? Do you have time to cook? Do you even cook? Like, there's so many things that come into play. And when I advise people about what to eat, I want to make sure it's something realistic for them to do. You know, I don't want to advise people to go on this plan and then it's not realistic for their lifestyle, you know? And, you know, what good does that do to anybody? It doesn't help the person. They just wasted money. Like, I just wasted energy, you know? So that's going to be a much higher price point. But I will have that available soon. I mostly had this in mind for my patrons, because when someone signs up to my Patreon, I already know these people really want to know about healthy eating, because they're paying a subscription fee every month for extra content specifically about healthy eating. So that's the main reason why I thought of this rating, is mostly for my patrons. So if you are a patron, I will be giving a discount on this kind of reading. But if you're not a patron, this food consultation will be much more expensive. So just letting you guys know what's coming to my Etsy shop. Yes, that is what's happening with me. Scorpio in the third house, you know. We do go deep. We do like to go deep, but at the same time, we like to have mystery to ourselves, keep things protected and private. So, I could talk about, you know, some other things, but you know, just like a lot of people during this time, you know, I'm going through a lot. I'm going through a lot of changes. And shout out to everyone who's currently going through their Saturn return. Or I just finished my Venus return. And I'm actually going through my Mars return. So shout out to anyone that's going through heavy transits with their astrology. And to add to that, you know, if you're into the nine star key, if you're going through one of the shadow periods of the nine star key, that's something I want to talk about on my podcast, on my YouTube channel some more, is more about the nine star key astrology, because I really feel like it's a more practical form of astrology for your everyday life. There's really some tangible things that you can do, realistic things that you can do that you can see the benefits immediately. You know, I honestly feel like nine star key astrology is easier for people to grasp than, you know, the other kind of astrology, tropical astrology, where it's all talking about the planets, because we can't see our planets. We can't see our solar system the way that it works. We can't physically see it. I mean, with the telescope, we can sometimes. Sometimes with the naked eye, we can mostly see the moon. But, you know, with the nine star key, it's about the changes on Earth, you know, the seasons. It's the energy that gives us cycles, night and day, The phases of a seed growing into a plant. It's very tangible. You can look out your window and see the nine star key easily, you know? So I would like to talk more about that at some point. And I would love to, if you guys, this is something I didn't talk about yet. On my Instagram, every Thursday, the day of Jupiter, the day of luck, expansion, laughter, party time, I do a live dinner. So I start the live with a prayer, saying gratitude for our food and thinking about what this food is going to do for us. And then we go through what we're eating and we all, you know, share our emotional hunger levels, physical hunger levels, and then we just eat together and we just talk. And if you want to share the screen with me and show me what you're eating, you can do that. And hopefully by the end of the meal, you know, our physical hunger and our emotional hunger levels are the same. And we feel full, but not too full. And another thing I really want to help people with is chewing their food well and being present in the moment with their food. So, of course, also too, to have community, you know, come together. Because I have felt in the past when I was going through my recovery from my eating disorder, it was really hard for me to be alone with food in a healthy and stable way. Because most of the time with my eating disorder, you know, every time I was alone with food, I was basically binging. You know, I was it was a very shameful thing for me, you know? So, when I was creating new patterns with my food, you know, being with people that I loved, supportive people of me, you know, having a normal meal, you know, it was really nourishing for me, you know, on more than one level. So, you know, as someone who is promoting a healthy lifestyle, especially with food, I feel like I am a great person to be eating with for people who are looking for that kind of support. So you can check me out, like I said, every Thursday at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. And we usually go for an hour. And then I always post the recording afterwards on my Instagram TV and also on YouTube. So you can see me there if you can't make it to the live. And I've also been more active on my Facebook group. If you guys have joined my Facebook group, Sacred Space for Sensitive Women, I started it last year, and you know, I initially made it because I was working with a business coach, and she said that that was a great place, a great thing to do to start, you know, having a community and stuff like that. And honestly, I got pretty overwhelmed and defeated while I was working with that business coach. So it made me want to quit everything. And so for a long time, I wasn't posting in that Facebook group. But now that I've taken some time off, I've regrouped, recalibrated, you know, I'm back on there and I feel really good about what I've been posting, and everything that's been going on in that group since then. So if you would like to join that Facebook group, it's totally free. You just have to answer a few questions. Again, I will leave the link in the description area of this episode. So if you answer all the questions and I feel like, you know, you're a good fit for our group, I'll totally let you in. And oh my gosh, right after this, I'm going to start, a new TikTok account. So if you guys didn't know, I started a TikTok account a few months ago when it was Mercury retrograde in Pisces. I know, well, all of you might be thinking, why did you do that, girl? I thought you knew about astrology. Why did you do that? Because during that time, I was just like, who even cares? I was in a defeated point, honestly. I was just kind of like, who cares? Whatever. Let me just do it, you know? But I've gotten some guidance from the_astrodim. You can find her on Instagram and TikTok. And she has been encouraging me to get on TikTok, and she actually gave me the advice to start a new account during the new moon. So the new moon happened just earlier today. So I'm gonna start a new TikTok account, and I've been you know, browsing the TikToks. And it seems like a really fun platform, and that's what I like to do, you know? A Gemini in the 10th house, that's so up my alley. And I already made one TikTok, and that's probably gonna be my first TikTok, or one of my first TikToks. It's a little recipe, 15-second recipe, so yeah, I'll leave my new TikTok account in the links as well. And I hope you guys will check me out, and let me know if you find me on TikTok. Say, hey, I heard you talk about your TikTok on the podcast. Oh, speaking of, I would love for you to give me a 5-star review wherever you listen to podcasts. I would really, really love it. I would really, really appreciate it. That really helps boost my podcast to be seen by more people, to get the message spread about health and happiness and our connection to nature. And I mean, the more that people know about this information, the better off our whole world will be. And isn't that, you know, the main concern right now? Isn't that what we're, if we're going to be general and overall, you know, that's the main concern right now, is to be healthy and happy and peaceful, you know, be able to get along with each other. And I really believe that what I have to share will definitely help people in that direction. And I'm so thankful. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna cry. I'm so thankful that that I can do that. So I think that's it for me today. Thank you so much for listening, for tuning in, and I hope you guys have a great rest of your day or evening. Peace.